Sid Meier's doesn't only do Civilization 5 and 6, he also had a thing for pirates in the late 80s, bleed through into the 90s, and then in 2005 it released on Steam. And if you're not a fan of old games and you don't like the subpar graphics, bear with me. I am with you on that, but I promise you, this is a wonderful story and a wonderful strategy game from Sid Meier and produced by Firaxis, just like Civilization. In this game, after you've decided your name and signed up to be a pirate, you choose your team, indeed pick your colonial poison, and head out into a Caribbean, a Central America worth exploring. Pirates is set in the Caribbean, and the pirates' playing field includes the Spanish Main, Central America, Gulf of Mexico, Florida, the Caribbean Islands, you name it. But let me tell you about what sets this action-adventure strategy game apart. There are four different pieces to it. You're going to see a brief capturing of all of them here. As I quickly dock my ship into the first town, you can start to see some of the political, the economic, and the, I suppose, power dynamics, city building, and character building dynamics of the game. Here you can see I'm talking to a governor who called me Mr. Jumbo. Far too polite. I can also head to the tavern to recruit people for my boat, to flirt with the bar maiden. Maybe I'll do that. But no, actually, she's got a handy tip for me about a pirate ship nearby. Indeed, when you dock in towns in Sid Meier's Pirates, you can gather intel for future missions, treasure maps, build networks, so on and so forth. I'm going to take advantage after taking advantage of the political functions by talking to the governor and hopefully trying to earn a promotion and maybe unlock some more game mechanics down the line, and picking up a few treasure maps and handy tips from the tavern, as well as some additional crewmates to man my ship. More on that later when we talk about combat, because this game has a doozy of a naval and kind of melee combat system as well. Anyway, I'll get to that. Other options, of course, include trade. Here you can see Jumbo with no capital J. How infuriating is trading with a merchant? Food to keep me alive, very important to feed my crew as well, and then a variety of goods. Of course, each port that you choose to dock in has different prices, supply and demand for all of these goods, so you can indeed be your own trader. But let's throw ourselves into the map and talk about what I argue is the main selling feature of this game, politics aside, that is sailing, and actually traversing the world. And while of course it's not a randomly generated world, the actors and players within it, while inspired by real life, their movements and actions can be randomized. In this playthrough, by the way, I decided to buddy up with the English, although that's not set in stone. So if you see me sailing after other ships like this Dutch smuggler, that's why. I'm probably going to hit 5 on my keypad and attack. Speaking of the keypad, it's important to note that whether you're traversing the map by sailing and traveling around as the game's intended, or in combat, more on this in just a second, you will be using these keys to do so. It's an older game. It can feel a little clunky at first, but once you get the hang of it, it kind of makes sense. And actually, I don't know, it sort of warmed on me a little bit as I was refreshing myself with Sid Meier's Pirates, which hopefully I won't accidentally call Sid Meier's Civilization 5 million times in this video. Either way, this is the second dynamic of the game, where the first is sailing and traveling, the second is battling your enemies, combat, and of course plundering. You can choose to keep or sink ships and add them to your collection. You will plunder gold pieces after successfully winning a fight and any goods your opponent may have been holding. You can choose to completely battle them at sea or raid their ship straight from the get-go and jump on board. More on that later, because it's probably one of the funkiest parts of this game. And actually fight yourself. Melee, hand, swords, combat, it's wild. But this, slightly sped up, mind you, in fact this is 3x speed, is another look at fighting in this game. Here I'm maybe taking on a little more than I could chew. It's a Spanish Royal Galleon. Thought I would change the view a little bit. I'd recommend you don't do that. But either way, in Pirates, you can choose to fight off a little bit more than you could chew. If your eyes are larger than your stomach, you can go for it. Or you can sail in. You can change the type of shot that you're firing. A chain shot for up close and personal to destroy their sails or wreck their ships. All the way out to longer range shots. And of course, you are manually controlling your ship. The wind direction changes, your opponents will change. The point here is that no battle is the same, and because it is manually controlled, much more so than... it's obviously not a very fair comparison, but much more so than Sid Meier's Civilization, a game which many of you watching this have probably played, and that's the reason why I draw to it. In this game, in Sid Meier's Pirates, it is really up to you. If you're sailing stupidly alongside the wind and there's no wind speed, you will sit still and look like an absolute idiot and maybe be sunk by the Spanish, or the slimy Spanish, or whatever the heck the in-game narrator likes to call them. Goodness gracious, that is not at all my opinion of Spanish people, by the way. Please do not hashtag cancel me. Anyway, moving on. The battling enemies combat dynamic of this game is fantastic, and it's one of the most enjoyable pieces, even if, like I say, it is a little bit clunky along the way. And of course, it builds part of a story. Here, by fighting that Spanish ship and achieving victory, an English governor has awarded me a promotion the next time I go to see them. So of course I'm gonna pull out my poorly drawn map and see if I can find Mavis Navis, check the goods prices in the town as well. You can see, you can do that anywhere from your map. If you're more interested in economics and trading, you might be more interested in that. But I'm gonna sail back here, talk to the governor, and get my promotion, which will unlock more features. Of course, as you work your way up through the ranks, you may be rewarded land, or potentially the chance to take the governor's daughter on a date, but more on that in a little bit. It's juicy. It's very juicy. Either way, I want to talk more now about politics and power in the game while you watch me fight a poor Indian war canoe that bought off more than it could chew, and maybe, just maybe, it should have sailed around the other way. I don't know. Either way, politics and power in this game is largely controlled by those colonial features, right? You have the English and the Spanish, so on and so forth. These colonial powers who you can buddy up with, fight against, earn prestige with one, and ruin your reputation with the other. It's entirely up to you how you would like to play it. There are other political actors, so to speak, in the game. From random characters that may appear on ships, like a particularly skilled chef who could potentially cook you some wonderful meals and merge as part of your fleet as you hopefully slowly build up a fleet like I'm doing here with my ragtag bunch of three ships. There are also, of course, notorious pirates. This is, after all, Sid Meier's Pirates, and you are also most likely a pirate. So it makes a lot of sense that there are famous pirates from throughout history in this game with their own notoriety, prestige, and all sorts of wonderful mechanics that help embed them as interesting and useful characters in a game which, let's be real, is relatively old and surprisingly not showing signs of its age. The last factor to discuss is the economy in this game, and as I've already hinted on, it is largely factored around your fleet and trading goods, plundering, trading, even digging up treasure, however you want to do it. Essentially, the economy is fixated around that. It's fixated around you purchasing, investing in more treasure maps or ships or upgrades, equipment, whatever it may be. The economy is focused around moving goods from one place to another, trading, bartering, and plundering, and reinvesting into yourself. It's a fairly straightforward economic system, and of course it reflects its time. When you combine it with random events like you may have seen pop up on screen just there, where a certain stronghold or ship or fleet or trade route is being attacked, it's a relatively interesting economic system, I have to say. Is it the best ever? No, but it suits the game perfectly. And as I move through here to talk to the governor to get my promotion and be introduced to his daughter, who when I become a baron I might even be able to go for a dance with. That, by the way, I would really encourage you to do. It is the most ridiculous, hilarious mechanic. And to reflect here at the end of the video, Sid Meier's Pirates is not Civilization. It's an open-sea action-adventure strategy game, I suppose. It's old. It does show its age in little ways. The resolution, for example. The graphics, obviously. Maybe the odd crash from time to time and relatively stripped back mechanics, but the way it weaves in interesting politics, dancing dates with governor's daughters, interesting Assassin's Creed Black Flag but 2 decades ago like sea battles, I think makes it an easy purchase, especially considering just how cheap this game is. You would expect as much, considering it's been out for some 20 or 30 odd years. Thank you very much for watching. I'll leave you with an embarrassing outtake. Do subscribe if you'd like to see more variety strategy content, and I'll see you next time. on an unusual resolution, and you may have a couple of instances where it crashes or doesn't perform. Siri, please! Or doesn't perform with... doesn't perform... Okay, no, that is ridiculous.